Back to STS. In today's tutorial, we're going to find the absolute maximum and minimum of a function over two distinct intervals. The first interval is from 0 to 2, and that's a closed interval. And the second one is from negative 3 to 1. And the function in question is f of x is equal to x cubed minus 3x minus 2. We begin by finding the first derivative so that we can locate the critical values. So f prime of x is equal to 3x squared minus 3. The constant negative 2, its derivative is 0, so I'll just leave that off. To find the critical values, we need to set this function equal to 0. And to solve this, I need to factor out the GCF from the right-hand side, and that GCF is 3. I'm left with x squared minus 1. I notice that x squared minus 1 is the difference of perfect square, so that can also be factored into x plus 1 times x minus 1. Now I need to set each one of these factors equal to 0. First factor is 3. Well, 3 equals 0 doesn't make sense, so I discard that. Next factor is x plus 1 equals 0. I subtract 1 from both sides, and here I see x is negative 1. For the other factor, x minus 1 equals 0, end up adding 1 to both sides, and here I have x is equal to 1. So here's my two critical values. Now let's find the second derivative. To find that, we need to take the derivative of the first derivative. 3x squared resolves to 6x, and again, the derivative of a constant is just 0. I said 6x, I actually meant, 6x. Let's get rid of that squared there. Now let's input each one of these critical values into the second derivative. So f double prime of negative 1, I end up with 6 times negative 1, which is negative 6. Negative 6 is less than 0. So I have a situation where I am concave down, and concave down indicates a maximum. Let's input the second critical value of a positive 1. So f double prime of 1 is equal to 6 times 1. Here we have 6 is greater than 0. So with it being greater than 0, I'm actually concave up, and concave up indicates a minimum. What I'm going to do first is concentrate on the first closed interval of 0 to 2. So let's create a chart. One side is x, the other side is f of x, and I need to test the endpoints. So I have a 0 and 2, and I need to pick the critical value that falls between this interval of 0 and 2, and that has to be the critical value of 1. Now I'm going to substitute these values of 0, 2, and 1 into the original equation. When I input a 0, that resolves to negative 2. When I input a 2, that resolves to 0. And when I input a 1, that resolves to negative 4. Now I'm going to look at my f of x, or my y values here, and let's figure out which one is the maximum and which one is the minimum. All right, let's begin with the maximum. Our largest number here is 0. So at 0.2, 0 is our max, and our minimum is at position 1, 4, because I mean 1, negative 4, because negative 4 is the smallest value. So that's our minimum. And now let's go ahead and call up the calculator so that we can test these values. All right, so let's go ahead and press y equals. You'll notice that I already have the function in place. Let's go ahead and graph it, and here's the graph. We're working on an interval of 0 to 2, so let's go to window. Let's put in the maximum value. I'm sorry, the minimum value is going to be 0. The maximum value is going to be 2. And now let's go down to y minimum. From what we saw in our table, the minimum value was negative 4, but I want to go just a bit further, so I'm going to make that negative 5. And we saw that the maximum value was 0. And I'm going to go a bit further and make that a 1. And then I'm going to go ahead and graph. All right, when the graph comes up, here we see it drawn in. This position here is a 0. That's 1, and that's 2 for the x values. We see that at 1, we are at a minimum. And at 2, we are at the maximum. We see here at position 0, we fall in between those two. Let's go ahead and just go to second and trace, and let's input those values. So let's select 1 for value. And let's begin with our first x value, which I said was 0, which is an endpoint. When we put that in, we see it does resolve to negative 2, like we said analytically. Let's put in our next x value of 1, which was the critical value. And we see that critical value comes in at negative 4, which we said was the minimum. And lastly, let's go to where x is 2 to get the value for this maximum. And we see that maximum value is at 0, just like we looked at analytically. Let's go ahead and switch back. And now let's work on B, which is going to be the second interval. And let's put that right here. The second interval is from negative 3 to 1. And again, I want to create a table, x and f of x. Put the endpoints on here first, which is negative 3 and a positive 1. We see that positive 1 is it's an endpoint, but it's also one of the critical values. And we see that negative 1 does fall in between the interval there. So let's put down a negative 1. And again, we're going to take these input values and substitute those back into our original function. When x is negative 3, we see that that there resolves to a y value of negative 20. When x is negative 1, we see that that there is going to give us a value of 0. And when x is 1, we've already figured out when x is 1, we get a value of negative 4. And now let's look to see where our maxes and mins are. We see that our largest value here is at 0. So at point negative 1, 0, we have a max. And our minimum is when the x value is negative 3, because we have our smallest y value of negative 20. So this here is going to be the min. And again, let's go back to the calculator so that we can test our analytical reasoning here. All right, let's go ahead and play with the window. All right, we said that the interval is from negative 3, so our minimum x value is negative 3. Our maximum x value is going to be 1. And now let's go down to our y min. We said that our minimum y value is negative 20. Let's make it negative 21 to give us a bit of space. And let's make the y max at 0, but we're going to keep it here at 1 again to have a little bit of space. And then let's go ahead and graph it. All right, when this is graphed in, we see that this here is negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, and the positive 1. As we look at this, we see that we have a maximum here at negative 1. Our minimum appears to be here at negative 3. And here, when we're at position 1, we see that we're in between that max and minimum. Let's go ahead and check those values. So we're going to press on second and then trace. Select number 1 to give us value. And let's start here at the far left with the negative 3. When I put in the negative 3, I'm expecting my output to be a negative 20. Negative 20. And here we have that. Let's now go to negative 1, where negative 1 should be our maximum. And that should be at position 0. So let's put in the negative and the 1. Enter. We see that comes out as 0 as our max. And then let's go to positive 1, which should give us another, which should show us negative 4 like it did in the previous graph. In the previous interval. So I put negative 4, actually meant negative 1. And the output it should give us is going to be, negative 1, positive 1. Put in a positive 1, which is here, and the output should be a negative 4. And here we do have the negative 4. Alright guys, that sums up this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on that Facebook channel and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. And as always, thank you for watching.